Aquila, Mari Imposita, Sexto Pompeo superato. Salute da TVN, siamo qui davanti alla grotta di Polifemo. Vi parleremo di Odysseus che sbarcò a...
The Grotta di Polifemo, located on the ridge of the Rocca on which the castle stands now, is a natural cave that housed the manufacture of dust and saltpeter in the 17th century. Enlarged by the military engineers in 1943 to install artillery, it was also used as a defense with a cannon aimed at the sea. In peacetime it became a shelter for shepherds, and a few years later it was transformed into a charming place where to spend pleasant evenings in the company of excellent music. A large entrance corridor led into a large circular room. In one wall a beautiful painting depicting Polyphemus stood out, with his eye observing from a distance the boat of Ulysses. In fact, popular beliefs want to see it as the ancient home in which Polyphemus imprisoned the astute Ulysses with his men. The legend tells that Polyphemus ruled the herds of the sun god. In this land, called Chersonesus of gold, sung by the Greeks for beauty, climate and fertility, when Ulysses, a man of multifaceted ingenuity, landed there after a shipwreck. Homer tells us that Ulysses, during his long journey back from the Trojan War, landed in the land of the Cyclops. Driven by curiosity, Odysseus reached the cave of the most terrible of all, Polyphemus, where he and his companions were captured by the giant. 6 of the 12 men chosen by Ulysses to explore the island were also eaten and devoured. Trapped in the cave of the Cyclops, whose entrance was blocked by a huge boulder, Ulysses devised a plan to escape Polyphemus' captivity. As a first move, he offered some very sweet and very strong wine to the Cyclops to make him fall into a deep sleep. Polyphemus liked the wine so much that he promised Ulysses a gift, but asked for his name. Odysseus, astutely, answered him then to call himself Nobody. "And I will eat last nobody," was the gift of the Cyclops. After that Polyphemus fell asleep deeply, dazed by the wine. Here is that Ulysses put into practice the second part of his plan. In fact, together with his companions, he had prepared a large stick made out of an olive tree which, once red hot, was planted in the eye of the sleeping Cyclops by the Greeks. Polyphemus screamed so loudly that he awakened his Cyclops from his sleep. They then ran to the door of his cave while Ulysses and his companions were hiding near the flock of Cyclops Polyphemus. The Cyclops asked Polyphemus why he had screamed so loud and why he was invoking help, and he told them that Nobody was trying to kill him. The Cyclops thought it drunk, then left him in his pain. The next morning, while Polyphemus let out his flock to free him, since he would no longer be able to guide him, Ulysses and his soldiers escaped thanks to another clever stratagem, which was part of the third part of his plan. Each of them clung to the fleece of a sheep's abdomen to escape the touch of Polyphemus as the Cyclops stood before the door of the cave, feeling each sheep out to prevent the Greeks from escaping. Ulysses, the last to leave the cave, clung to the larger Ares, the favorite of the Cyclops. Realizing the Greeks' escape, Polyphemus pushed himself onto a promontory, where, blindly, he began throwing rocks against the sea, trying to sink the ship. Here Ulysses made a mistake. At the umpteenth blank shot of the giant, Ulysses laughed and shouted, "If someone asks you who has blinded you, answer that it was not Odysseus, Nobody, but Ulysses of Ithaca," thus revealing his true name. Polyphemus, having come to know the identity of the Greek, had to curse him, invoking his father Poseidon and begging him not to return him to his homeland.